And for the first time, scientists have discovered a lake full of water on the planet Mars. For decades, scientists have been hunting for any sign of water on the planet. There was evidence that water existed there in the past, but now to find this pool suggests the possibility of life on Mars, of course. Well, retired NASA astronaut Leroy Chow with us here. So as an astronaut, I have to wonder, what was your initial reaction to the fact that they found this? And it's a significant amount of water comparatively to what they found before, yes?
That's correct. And these are data that have been obtained over a number of years from a European Space Agency spacecraft. And using radar imaging, they have determined what looks to be like a large body of liquid water kind of sandwiched between two ice layers in the South Pole, of the ice pack down there on the South Pole. And that's really exciting because, as you know, water is one of the requirements for life as we know it. It doesn't prove that it's there, but it shows that the conditions could be possible for it to exist.
So what are the implications for future human missions to Mars? I would think this would be a real focal point.
Right. Of course, any future human mission to Mars, you know, one of the things that the astronauts will be looking for is water, number one, for, you know, to determine if it's there, if it's subterranean, whether we can get to it, what kind of clues it might offer as to past or even current, some kind of microbial or other life on Mars. But also, you know, the water is something, if you're going to be staying for a long term, you're going to be looking at what's called in situ resource utilization. So you're going to be looking at how can you use that water? How easy is it to get to the surface? Can you, in fact, purify it so that you can drink it? Can you crack it using electrolysis so that you can generate oxygen for breathing? Things like that. So pretty significant.
Beyond what we might learn about life forms, anything else significant about this to you? Anything else that can be learned?
Well, this is very exciting because just a month ago, a little bit over a month ago, NASA made an announcement that the Curiosity rover drilled down into sedimentary rock in the bottom of what used to be a big lake billions of years ago, and it found the presence of methane in the sedimentary rock. And that's exciting because methane is a possible byproduct of a biological process. And how did it get down in that rock? Well, you can imagine that lake, you know, billions of years ago, at the bottom there's mud, there's silt. If there was some kind of life going on there producing that methane, and then over the eons, more silt and more mud piled on, creating that sedimentary rock, it would have trapped the methane. That's not proof that there was life on Mars, but it's an exciting possibility. So that coupled with this recent announcement of what appears to be a large liquid lake, that's pretty exciting because that implies that the conditions, at least perhaps billions of years ago, was conducive to some kind of life on Mars. And who knows, there could be some kind of microbial life or remnants today. But I mean, that's a little bit of a speculation and a stretch, but it's exciting.
Sure. I just want to see your face, Leroy, if it ever comes to fruition. If they ever come out and say, oh my goodness, we found life on Mars. I want a camera on you right then and there, because I think that would be
fun. Oh yeah, absolutely.
Oh, thank you, Leroy, so much as always. Leroy Chow.
My pleasure, thanks.